Good afternoon. Welcome to this media event, which is Oral Health for an Aging Population. I would just like to introduce you to our panel, which is, it starts with, from left to right, it's Professor Bolesław Semolinski, who is head of the Department of Prevention of Environmental Hazards and Allergology at the Medical University of Warsaw, and author of over 200 publications and numerous books, including a white paper on aging. He is founder of the Coalition for Healthy Aging and founder of the Healthy Aging Foundation. Professor Semolinski is involved in a number of initiatives for the elderly and policies for elderly people in Poland and abroad. Next, we have Mr. Makoto Nakao. He is the president and CEO of GC International AG in Switzerland and chairman of GC Corporation in Japan. Mr. Nakao has been playing a strong leadership role in the world dental industry, such as president of International Dental Manufacturers for 2 years from 1994. He's chairman of the Japan Dental Trade Association for 6 years from 2005. Throughout his top management activities for almost 40 years, Mr. Nakao has been promoting vision management, putting GOM as a core, and was awarded the Denning Prize for Individuals from the Union of Japanese Scientists and Engineers in 2012. Now we have Dr. Patrick Esko. Dr. Patrick Esko is president of FDI World Dental Federation. He has been an expert on oral health for the World Health Organization and director of a WHO collaborating center since 1998. He's also been advisor to the French Ministry of Health and Solidarity. He is also a former president of the French Union for Oral Health and a former secretary general of the French Dental Association. Dr. Esko has been involved in the FDI Oral Health for an Aging Population Partnership since its inception in 2015. Finally, I'd like to present Professor Honorata Shaw. Professor Shaw is currently International Vice President of the Polish Dental Society. She is Professor Emeritus of Poznan University of Medical Sciences and was Dean of the Medical Faculty at that university from 1999 to 2005. She is a recognized expert in endodontics and is also involved in teaching communication skills at both under and postgraduate levels. Thank you. We'll start with Professor Semolinski, who will open the debate. Then we will have a presentation from Dr. Esko, afterwards from Mr. Nakawa, and afterwards from Professor Shaw. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Oh my God, I'm sorry. This is great pleasure to be here today. I'm not dentist, I'm allergologist and ENT specialist, but I'm today together with you because I'm also public health specialist, and for years I was the national consultant in this field. And also in the past, in 2011, I was responsible for the Polish priorities during Polish presidency in European Union. This is very important because during that time, exactly 19 of September 2011, there was declaration voted in the New York of United Nations during United Nations Assembly on non-communicable diseases. And in spite of that, we discuss in European Union from that time till now the problem of the non-communicable diseases and the problem of the new situation because of the changing of demography, especially in our country, but very similar to Japan. We have very, very low fertility and very, very high prolonged time of the life expectancy. The general problem is that when we are discussing of the reason why we have disability in the population of older people, we do not discuss in the public field, in media, we do not take into consideration in the health policy the problem of oral health. And this is very, very important that we have occasion to discuss this problem today. Why? Because at present we have over 2 billion people over 60. Among them 400 million people are over 80. And the quality of life of these people depends on different things, especially on oral health and all those risk factors which lead to the loss of teeth are responsible for malnutrition and nutritional deficiency, and also suppress the quality of life of this population. This is the reason why we'd like to show you three presentations, starting with Dr. Patrick Heskott. So the floor is yours.
Thank you. Yes, I would like to present FDI firstly. FDI is the principal official representative body for over 1 million dentists worldwide. We are present in a lot of countries, more 130 countries, and we have 200 national member associations. For example, in Poland, we have the Polish Chamber and the Polish Society. And it's very important for us to be present around the world because we are a federation of national dental associations, and our vision is leading the world to optimal oral health. And we can that not directly, but with our national dental associations. We are currently in partnerships with GC, International of Japan, to ensure oral health challenges in broader disease policies for aging populations. Today, we are focusing on oral health and an aging population. As you can see from this graph, in all regions, rich, middle income, or low income, there is a gap of approximately 10 years between life expectancy and HC life expectancy. Oral disease is generally not life-threatening, but poor oral health is certainly a quality of life issue. With people living longer, we need to be able to transform simple life years into healthy life years. This should be life years where people can continue to be independent, to be able to chew, to eat, and enjoy a good quality of life, and to have a social life. And it's very, very, very important for the aging population. But to enjoy good oral health throughout life, there is also a need to transform the way that people at all stages of life perceive oral health from their first moments as well as the oral hygiene they practice throughout the life course. Aging strategies, 50 years of the life, will depend to a large extent on preventive measures and population education undertaken today. Thank you. Yes. As you can see, a healthy and functional dentition is a fundamental part of general health and well-being. The mouth is a mirror of the body, often reflecting signs of systematic disease. Many general conditions increase the risk of oral diseases, such as an increased risk of periodontal disease in patients with diabetes. Equally poor oral health can adversely affect a number of general health conditions and their management. Different ages in life have different oral health needs, and the specific problems for older people who are often also suffering from other diseases are becoming more prevalent. Knowledge and awareness of the close associations between oral and general health are thus important for holistic care, as is collaboration between oral and general health professionals. Why you need a healthy mouth? Attention to oral health care has been shown not only to promote maintenance of a natural healthy and functional dentition, but also contributes to survival in older adults. Maintaining optimal oral health reduces the risk of suffering from non-communicable disease and promotes healthy aging. Healthcare providers should prepare for an increased need of oral health services for dented older adults as a complete tooth loss among older adults is declining. It is also important for us to understand that age-associated changes in systematic health and medication use can impact oral health and function. Optimizing the physical, mental, and social well-being of seniors is the key to preserving their autonomy and quality of life. For example, oral pathologies are among the most frequent causes and consequences of the malnutrition often observed among the elderly living with chronic conditions. Trouble with swallowing and digestion can also lead to malnutrition. Poor oral health can have a significant negative impact on the quality of day-to-day life. Bad breath, loss of taste, mucosal injury, pain, speech disorder, social withdrawal, and depression, and so on. Effective oral hygiene becomes increasingly difficult with advancing years due to decreasing manual dexterities from chronic conditions such as osteoarthritis, rheumatism, and often now Parkinson's disease. Improving the oral health of the elderly is therefore a major public health issue for us. This is why aging has become a focal point for FDI. Dentists play a major role in two very key elements of the modern society. For everybody, for all of you, the self-esteem of the individual and your quality of life. What is the most important for you? Your self-esteem and your quality of life. Their task is spread over five areas. Educate, inform, diagnose, treat, and maintain. The dentist is not for cure. The dentist is for educate, inform, diagnose, treat, and maintain. This is where the added value of the dentist is to be found in oral health as an essential aspect of the individual in the move from highly skilled technician to healthcare practitioner now. Maintaining oral health through life has always been an objective of the Dental Committee. And I would like to thank the Japan Dental Association, and the Japan industry with GC. Japan is the most advanced aging society in the world, and the Japan Dental Association took the lead in organizing the first World Congress in 2015 in Tokyo. Dental care and oral health for healthy longevity is an aging society in Tokyo in March 2015. It was co-sponsored by WHO and FDI. And its call for action, the Tokyo Declaration highlights, for example, the need for research, evidence-based national dental health care policies, recognition of oral and dental health throughout life as fundamental to improving quality of life and helping to protect against non-communicable disease. Appropriate dental care throughout the life, a common risk factor approach to prevent oral disease and tooth loss, and an environment that enables and encourages multi-professional collaborative practice. The full text is included in your media kit and can also be downloaded from the WHO website. Inspired by the Tokyo Declaration, FDI set up a task team to focus on oral health for an aging population. It first met in August, September 2015. Among its decisions was to organize an expert conference on sea every 2 years. The first was held in Lucerne, Switzerland. I think we have the president of the Dental, the Dental Association from Switzerland. And we work with him and we prepare a big event. 5 aspects were discussed and will be presented during the symposium here in Potsdam on 10 September. And we invite you to join us at this moment. And you can see here, I will be, I was in Warsaw in March in the Senate, and I was invited by the Minister of Health and by the President of the Senate to explain our point of view, to explain the responsibility of the oral health, and to explain the relation between oral health and general health, and also this new evolution of the dentist. And it's primordial to advocate that. And I explain you too also, during this meeting, during this event, we have a very, very, very important news. FDI today has a new definition of the oral health. And with this new definition of the oral health, we can imagine a new vision of the dentist, a new vision of our profession, a new vision for the future. And after, all the dental association can pose and present this new aspect of the dentist and the dentistry. It's very important to have an evolution of our image. Our image to be positive and to explain that we are not after the pain, not after for treatment. We are here for the quality of life. And for aging population, it's compulsory. Today, there is an urgent need to reverse this negative thinking about aging. We need to clearly demonstrate that investing in health and oral health throughout the life course can reduce the costs of aging and enable seniors to live full lives. The choice is ours. Do we take the negative burden option or do we choose the positive option? By investing in health and oral health throughout the life course, we can reduce the cost of aging as well as ensuring the optimal quality of life, well-being and social participation for everybody and in particular for our seniors. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for this presentation. The most important thing, I think, for public health is that dental caries, periodontal disease and tooth loss, what you said, generally oral health, are the main, one of the important risk factor for non-communicable diseases. It's very, very important to remember that, and thank you for this information and this very, very important sentence. So the next lecture will be presented by Makoto Nakao. So welcome. The floor is yours.
Good afternoon. I'm very honored and privileged to be here with you. Now, I would like to explain to you our footstep for aging population. So 1988, from we introduced vision management system into our group company. Then 2004, we challenged most difficult total quality management assessment, so-called Japan Quality Medal. At this assessment, I promised to assessor, we will promote vision management concept to dentistry. Then 2005, I became president of Japan Dental Trade Association. JDTA is full body of our dental industry in Japan. Then I became a president, Then I started to work together with JDA, Japan Association, Dr. Okubo, and Japan Academy for Dental Science, Dr. President Eto. We started to create our vision. Then 2007, finally, we created vision for future dental material equipment business. Then, reply to our vision paper, Japanese government and Minister of Health replied on their new medical device and medical technology industry in Japan. Then this was really first time they mentioned importance of dentistry. Besides that, they asked us to industry, dental association, and academia. We have to pay more attention into aging society. So, for our second version of our vision, we published 2012. We started new project team with Dental Association and academia people to develop the materials to equipment total for visiting dentistry. During this period, 2012, President of JDA, Dr. Okubo, he made a presentation on current dental situation in Japan. Furthermore, effectiveness of 80-20 movement in Japan. Then finally, 2015, already President Hescott mentioned, Dr. Okubo hold Tokyo meeting, World Congress, Dental Care and Oral Health for Healthy Longevity in an Aging Society. So beside that symposium, 1,500 people gathering all over the world, we had a dental exhibition. On this occasion, our project team could successfully introduce so-called DentaPack Kokoro from materials, equipment, total system for visiting dentistry we developed. Then they declared Tokyo Declaration. Immediately after World Congress, we had a press conference. At that moment, President TC1 and President-elect Dr. Hescott, they announced FDI is going to continue this activity worldwide. And also, I promise GC is going to continuously support FDI activities. So already Dr. Hescott mentioned, last year, August, first meeting was held. Furthermore, last May in Lucerne, 24 professional participants we received, and we had a Lutheran conference. So coming Saturday, they are going to make a report on 5 themes. Then, year 2000, we introduced minimum invasive concept to dentistry as a first company. Then, as you know, dental company has 2 big important missions. One is to develop, to materialize, and third one is to consumerize the systems and products. Second mission is continuously we have to improve our corporate social responsibility. By those two reasons, we, GC, we are going to continuously support FDI activities. And furthermore, this year we celebrate 95th anniversary. So this special project is our centennial project. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And the last presentation is prepared by Professor So.
Thank you very much. And in fact, it's not a presentation. Is it better now? No, something wrong with the and this will be progressing. Fertility is lowering, longevity is going up. It's progress. Medicine is supporting us with the tools to be healthy for a long time and to live longer, but not everything is designed properly. One of the problems is our oral cavity. Physiology is changing with age. Production of saliva is main culprit of many problems. Caries, periodontal disease, inflammation. So first of all, we are losing hard tissue, but also the tissue with supporting tooth. That is why elderly people very often have to extract their teeth and has to be supported with artificial dentition called denture, which is very diminishing your self-esteem. I know funny story and I will tell you, but it's very sad story. Long ago, one of the gentlemen in the society sneezed and his denture jumped out and was taken by the dog, you know, and bite by the dog. So if you have this possibility of losing your teeth or not use them properly, psychologically is very damaging. Also, ability to chew, which is very important for our alimentary system, which as a consequence supports our body with nutrition. If you can't chew your food properly, you start to search for something which is easy to eat, and these easy products are usually carbohydrates, and again, here is caries coming. So older age has facing multidisciplinary problem. It's they can't use proper vegetables, raw vegetables the best, so the food we are using is less healthy. Our dexterity is not good enough to clean our teeth properly. Very often in old age, social situation is also decreasing, is not very good. And all this is connected often with ill health and many medicine drugs which elderly patients have to use. The using drugs, especially psychotic drugs, has side effect, very, very sad side effect, reducing saliva again. So the syndrome of dry mouth is a common problem and also leading to some, between many other mentioned before, troubles, caries, periodontal disease, also oral cancer. Because if the surface of our mucus is very dry, very easily damaged. And constant damaging of the surface is leading to growing neoplasm tissue. I can't help with this, sorry. Anyway, if you have any question, I would say a few words about situation in Poland. I have some numbers here. We are not in a good place when elderly population is concerned. With many problems, but if we are aware of this, we can do something. According to WHO, World Health Organization, between 2015 and 2050, means in period of 35 years, the proportion of world population over 60 will nearly double. It's for 35 years have the problem twice as bad as it is before. It's really very warning signal. In Poland, recently there was some research done in Wrocław Medical University and Dresden University, and statistics says that every second Polish person, means 50% above 65, have no their own dentition. Yeah? They have to use dentures. Of course, according to the research, 85% of this population is using dentures. The others are not using at all. If you ask a person who uses denture, he will or she will explain that it's very complicated. Very often you can have some damaged mucosa underneath. They are simply wounds on the surface, so they will remove. So their denture. Very difficult to accept because mastication is changing. Our muscles has to use to new situation. It's not, our muscles are not elastic as they were before. So adapt any new treatment done in the oral cavity is very difficult. Every patient knows that often after simple filling put in our teeth, we have some trouble. It's not so easy at the beginning. We need sometime help of the dentist. But have all dents new completely and learn how to use it is a really great effort. Probably this 15% which is not supplied with dentures may also not use it because it's too complicated, too difficult. Also, we have to remember that elderly people has not very good memory. The situation, all life conditions are changing dramatically. To compare with other countries, to be even more sad than before, according to WHO report, Health for All in 21st Century, the data are for Poland. They are a tiny bit old, but because it's 2011 and 12. For Poland, we learned that for senior patient, only 20% of this patient received any treatment in dental surgery. So above 65, only 25% of this population had access to the dental surgery. When to compare with Sweden, Sweden is the first place in the world when oral health is concerned, 80% of the dental senior citizens are attending dental surgery. They have access to dental surgery. And in Denmark is similar, 79%. But these countries are known for all the world for their policy, which was based on prevention, and they are successful, starting with education of the population. I think that I shouldn't talk about this problem anymore. I expect that you have your own questions, which would you would like to clarify or ask me. Any question, answer, even how old I am.
Any question from the audience? Welcome. So the time is running, so we have not more time to discuss the subject, but I'd like to summarize this meeting that this is very important, that we have such very, very important world meeting on dental health in Poznań. Poland is very active in the public health. We have just the new regulation, new act on that. This is the act on public health and also the national program on public health, which will be prepared and just implemented in our health policy in coming few months. What is very important that oral diseases affects almost 4 billion people in the world. It's 44% of the whole population, world population, is the most prevalent of all 291 health conditions. So this is very important to remember it. And what is the main message? That these diseases are preventable. So we can prevent to oral diseases, and also we can treat them. We have very, very big innovations and a lot of innovations in this field. So working on that is the general issue, the general challenge for all of us. Thank you very much. Thank you.